What is up, my ninja? Shinobi here with another Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls video for you guys. And I know that I've been doing quite a bit of wizard gameplay and such on my channel here and on my live stream. Did a lot of ladder climbing with it over the past few months here, and finishing the season at rank 26, getting to rank 1, getting, you know, up and down, kind of bouncing up and down in the ranking. And next season, I most likely won't be doing wizard in the beginning of the season, and people have been asking me for, like, crazy, give us a wizard guide. You know, if you're gonna switch on to another class coming up soon, at least give us that wizard guide. What are we shooting for in season 2? What is our, you know, beginning gonna look like? What is our middle gonna look like? What's our end gonna look like? What are some, like, build variations? And what are we wearing when you achieve those, you know, higher ranks multiple times? So watch what I'm gonna do in this video. We're gonna talk about 5 different things. So we're going to start with, like, end game type gear. We're going to get to end game type spec, and then we're going to get to item variations, build variations, and then kind of a starter guide near the end of the video. So hopefully you guys do enjoy this video, and hopefully it is very helpful to you. If it is, subscribe, like, comment, all that kind of stuff. And I do want to let you guys know that this is the first part of a 6-part series where we're going to be covering every class in the game. So if Wizard's not your thing, I'm teaming up with some really top-end Diablo 3 players, streamers, and YouTubers to go over, analyze, and give tips about each class, and hopefully getting all those videos out throughout this week. So be subscribed and be checking your inboxes for those videos. Going to be trying to pump them out as quick as possible, hopefully before season 2 starts on February 13th, this Friday. So let's go ahead and get into everything. Now we're going to get into the first thing, and that is the end game gear, what it kind of looks like. So right here, this is pretty much the full item build that I ran with on the higher tiers to get those multiple high ranks. And I'm going to go over each piece of gear, what kind of stats you're looking for, and also how to kind of optimize this gear, because I talk about this a lot in my streams. I have for quite a while now. It is very important to optimize your gear. And you can use this kind of strategy with pretty much every class in the game, but there are some situations that are a little bit different. But making sure you balance your stats correctly can separate a good geared character to a great geared character. So let's get into the item build. So first off, you have to have your Firebird. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if you're new to the Firebirds, or maybe you don't know exactly how the Firebirds works, the 6-piece set here is going to, when you ramp up your damage, you do fire damage, you get to that 3,000% weapon damage, you're going to infinitely tick over and over and over again. You can stack additional damage into there if you have additional burning things. For instance, the black hole, which sends a tick over a few seconds, and also your blizzard helps out with that, and your hydra. So that's why, you know, it starts off, you may see if you're playing a firebird wizard, it may see that you know, it starts ticking, you know, it starts off slow because it hasn't hit the firebird tick cap yet, and then when it does, it gets up to like 120 million, 120 million, 170 million per tick, and you're like, whoa, what happened there? And it's because, you know, you're adding additional damage stacking within that, and yeah. So that is the Firebirds in a nutshell. Now let's take a look at the first item here. I have the Firebird's Helm, going with Int, Vitality, 6% crit chance, and a socket, of course, and the optimized stat of having resistance in the secondary. This is very important. You can make up for a lot of survivability in your secondary. Resistance is a secondary stat for you. Now sometimes you may not be able to get, you know, resistance in the secondary, but you're just going to have to keep farming. The very first full set of Firebirds gear that I had collected in season 1, I'm not wearing a single one of those pieces right now, because I've literally had to collect Firebirds 10-20 times to get the gear the way I wanted, the stats that I wanted, and to push my character a little bit stronger, maybe a little bit more damage and a little bit more survivability. So this is a, you know, perfect example of what an optimized piece of gear looks like. The monster kills grants experience is okay. You might want, like, pickup radius or something to help you with those health globes, but just an example there. Now we do have our first ancient piece that I'm going to go over here. Now this is not ideal because I do have resist all in the primary here, which is something I just told you that you want to try to avoid. But I felt like the way that my gear was balanced at the time when I got this item, it was okay to use it. And if I did find, you know, an optimized Firebird shoulder that's ancient that I could put in the secondary, you know, that's great. So I ended up going with this because I did get more vitality. I did get more int, and yeah. And I tried rolling more int, vitality there, but, you know, it does take quite a while. And you know, getting that up higher there. But so the stats here: int, vitality, resistance, Hydra damage, which is going to be very helpful. They did change the Hydra recently to be a little bit more interactive with your character. I wouldn't try to stack Hydra damage too much, but it is helpful. You know, you don't want to sacrifice too many stats for it because it doesn't make that big of a difference on the way that your Firebirds kind of interacts with it. But the stats you're looking for on an item like this would be int, vitality, armor, Hydra, and then secondary would be the resistance. That's kind of what you're looking for, but unfortunately I didn't hit the nail on the head there. Now right here we have the Cinder Coat. Now we are going to talk about item build variations and things like that, but the Cinder Coat here, getting that fire damage, which was great, the reduce resource cost, couldn't even say that, doesn't really play that big of a factor. I mean, you're not really going to be spamming your abilities very often, but it is helpful sometimes. It can be very helpful to, you know, you pretty much get to use your Blizzard as much as you want to, and it can be helpful, especially if you're power leveling people. Definitely go with the Cinder Coat, but mainly the Cinder Coat is chosen for a couple reasons here. One is because of the fire damage there, and then two, because the secondary actually rolled pretty well with the reduced damage from ranged monsters, which is very helpful. You know, you're a kiting class and ranged monsters can mess you up, so you have to be careful of those ranged monsters. But yeah, so this is pretty good. Another, we'll talk about the item variations in a little bit, so we'll get into that, but so let's get into the next item here. So we have the Firebird gloves. Now you could go for trifecta gloves, but I felt like my toughness, you know, you want to try to shoot for at least 16 million toughness, and that's including having, you know, fully self-buffed. At least 16 million toughness, especially when you're getting to those higher tiers, you might do some item variations, which I'll talk about soon. But yeah, 16 million is like the bare minimum you should get to, because otherwise you're going to be in big trouble, taking way too much damage from even white mobs, and it's unfortunate. So I did keep the vitality here. You can see that I do have resistance in the secondary. I have chance to stun, which is interesting, crit chance, crit damage, and int right there with the vitality. So, interesting item. And then we move on to the amulet. Now, this amulet is actually pretty good. It's not the best amulet for the Firebird Wizard. I'll talk about what those would be in a little bit. I tried finding those other items like crazy, but this one here actually worked out to be kind of good. I had the life on kill in the secondary, which is interesting. Got fire damage, crit chance, and obviously using the socket there. Now, another thing that people always ask me is they notice that I'm not using int on here. Now, if you're using an ancient amulet or ring, yes, int is okay to keep on there sometimes, depending on your gear setup. However, right here, going with the fire, which I would like to get more fire here, I'd like to get more crit damage, you know, not the best optimized item, but definitely helpful, and, you know, you get more damage by keeping the damage multipliers than like something like int, you know, if it's not ancient. So because these items don't go up, these stats don't go up when it goes ancient, whereas they do with like int, vitality, and things like that. Now the special property on here is quite interesting. It summons these shadow clones, which they cast random wizard abilities, and sometimes they can cast you know, very interesting things like slow time, which helps you against range monsters. So this is pretty interesting versus in a lot of situations, and this procs every 30 seconds, and it can proc because you're using your vengeance here, and vengeance is helpful because it has a 20% chance to stun on hit. So you actually do have a chance to proc the shadow clones here, and it usually procs every 30 seconds. So keep that in mind, and it, you know, is somewhat helpful. Then we have the Strongarm bracers. Reapers. These ones are ancient. Unfortunately, they only roll 20% of the damage here. Now, you'd want to go with, you know, as close to 30% as you can. You can see that I have these ones over here that even though I would lose 2.4% damage when I knock back enemies with my black hole, I would actually get, you know, an additional 7% damage. So I decided to go with the more, I decided to go with the more guaranteed damage over long periods of time, especially versus a Rift Guardian. You're not going to have that knock-up effect versus the Rift Guardian, so this gave me better Rift Guardian times by having more a sustained item. But both can be argued to be pretty equal. And you can see resistance in the secondary, int vitality, crit chance, fire damage. Now we have the Witching Hour. Now, Witching Hour is not going to be something you're going to find right away. If you do find Witching Hour, great. If not, it's not that big of a deal. There are other things you can do, which we'll talk about. But Witching Hour is definitely good. And, you know, it gives you a lot of damage. It gives you about 10 to 12% damage. You do lose a considerable amount of toughness, but you can try to make up for it with getting Int Vitality and Resistance in the secondary and trying to get the highest stats that you can there. Now we have Unity, the double Unity combo. You know, people have asked me about this. Maybe you're newer to the game, you don't know what double Unity combo is. Well, double Unity combo is essentially you put one on yourself and one on your follower, and then you also have the your follower cannot die thing. So you're pretty much negating 50% of the damage by doing that, and it is a very strong combo and definitely needed. Now you can see here that arcane resistance in the secondary. We have elite damage maxed out at 15%. We have crit chance and crit damage, which are both quite high here. Definitely a good unity. So pretty good. Now we have the Stone of Jordan. Once again, kind of the same type of thing. We get the fire damage, high crit damage, high elite damage. We have resistance in the secondary, and then we also have life after kill. And obviously the socket for, you know, each one of these three. Stone of Jordan is very strong, but we're going to talk about some item variations in just a little bit. Now we have the pants here. You can see Int Vitality, Armor, then you want Resistance in the secondary. Pickup Radius is nice. There's other things that would be helpful, but not a big deal. And then two sockets. Here, kind of the same thing. Int Vitality, Armor, Movement Speed, Resistance in the secondary. And this is a big question that I get very often. Why is it that you have Movement Speed here? Well, you have to look at your options. So let's go over to, if we were to re-roll this, for instance, let's take a look. So what are our options here? Well, Meteor, we don't use that. We don't use any of this stuff here. Okay, so you're pretty much getting life regen, which is okay. Life regen's good, but if you would put life regen right here, that means in your paragons you're gonna have to spend life. You're gonna have to spend your paragon points into movement instead of putting it into intelligence. So you actually get more int by using movement on your boots. So that's why I go with it. You know, you get a little bit more survivability through that because int equals resistance, and you also get, you know, more damage. So definitely, in my opinion, the best way to go. Now, in your offhand here, very great item. We have the Firebird's Eye. Now, this is not optimized exactly the way I want it. The damage is pretty high. The fire damage could be higher. The int is okay. The crit chance is good. And then you have reduced cooldown, which is not a huge deal for wizards. I'd rather have a lot of vitality there because you can get up to 1,000 vitality, which would have been very helpful. But my character's health is about 700k. You want to shoot for at least 650k, especially if you're using a Witching Hour. So now we have Devastator. This is a craftable item. This is one of the first ones that I crafted, so I got pretty lucky. And you can see that the damage here goes up to 1940, got it to 1908. Pretty nice. The fire damage doesn't matter that's on that. They changed that a while ago. And then at 20% fire damage, you want to get the 10% damage, you want to get the int and the socket. So I did use a gift here, one of these right here. I did use one of these. So ideally, if it did come with a socket, you'd want to roll the socket to your percent damage or whatever it is you needed that you didn't get. So it looks like this, and then you wanted to put a gift on there, and that's just the easiest way to do it. So yeah, that's pretty much what you want to do. So yeah, this is pretty much the gear setup as it stands. You have about 8,500 armor. So you want to have at least 8,200 armor, and that's with your energy armor buff on. You want to have a considerable. You can see my resistance is actually pretty decent. I'm not even using like all resist in many of these areas. You do have a lot of int. You get, the gems. You use the int here, which is great. And yeah, so I do get a decent amount of resistance throughout everything here. So it does help out with a lot of outfixes like Arcane, Jailer, things like that. These immediate damage that comes on you and you can't really do much about. So yeah, and you can see all the stats right here. I'm getting that 25% movement speed. Let's take a look at the Paragons real quick. Now, Paragon here, what you want to do is you want to obviously first you want to get your movement speed like we talked about earlier, and then int as much as possible there. And then over here, you have your priorities set up. Now, your priorities are crit chance and crit damage. The way you figure out which one you need more is by looking at how much you have currently. So if you take a look at details, you can see that I have 505% crit damage and 55% crit chance. So if I was choosing between the two, I would want crit damage because it's a 10 to 1 ratio. So for instance, if I had 500 crit damage and 50 crit chance, that's even. So it's a 10 to 1 ratio the way that it works there, and that's how you know which one you need more of. That's how you're gonna get the more bang for your buck, and you can always mess up the numbers to see what helps you the best as well by looking at your damage before and after. But that just goes for any class, really. So yeah. So that is that. And then so you want to prioritize those. Now attack speed is something you can go with. You can go with it. Now attack speed does interact with your Hydra. It doesn't really interact with anything else that you do because your dot is a per second thing. So the attack speed is helpful with the Hydra. You're going to get more damage, which is great. Now, the cooldown isn't really a huge deal. Yes, you get to use Black Hole more often, but I feel like the attack speed is going to give you more damage. But you could, I think both of them are both viable options. These are like, you can go maybe cooldown here next or whatever. So you'd want to get these two first, and then kind of either one is fine. And then obviously if you're higher Paragon, you can get all of them, so here your biggest ones first. Armor is going to be the first one you want, and then resist all is going to be the second one you want, and then life percent is going to be the third one that you want, and regen is last. Now you have here, you want your resource cost reduction first, your area damage and life on hit, kind of similar. You don't really get life on hit. The way that life on hit works with the Firebird Wizard is you would think, oh, when I cast this, each one of these fireballs that are coming down is healing me for 8,000, right? No. It gives you life on hit for the first activation. So you get that 8,000 health per click. So you go, oh, healed for 8,000. Oh, healed for 8,000. So that's why another reason why it's useful to have Cindercoat here. But I believe that you have to wait till the first falling of them is done and then a reactivation after. So it doesn't really help that much considering you have quite a bit of health. But it is, it's better than nothing, right? You don't really have a lot of options. You don't need Goldfire, the Greater Rifts, or anything like that. So yeah, these three right there. And that is that. So now we're going to go into the next part here, which is talking about the spec. All right, now let's go ahead and take a look at the spec here, and this is what I run most of the time, but there is some variation there, and we will talk about that. So, Hydra, Mammoth Hydra. Now, another one that's pretty good is Blazing Hydra, but the thing is Blazing Hydra, the majority of the progression you're going to get in Greater Rifts is going to be up to the Rift Guardian. The Rift Guardian is going to take a while anyways. And yes, Blazing Hydra would be ideal for the Rift Guardian, but the majority of the entire time you're in the Rift is going to be other stuff. Big trash packs, big elites, lots of monsters. So Mammoth is going to give you more AoE and more damage. So that's kind of the clear one to go with. And it does interact with your Firebirds, as we talked about earlier. Blizzard with Apocalypse is quite nice. It's going to help you with getting the fire damage ramped up for your whole wizard thing, for your Firebird thing, which is great. And yeah, definitely helpful. And aggro, one reason why this is so good is because the radius is so big. You can aggro a lot of monsters together. You can kind of, pull them in with your black hole and then kind of, kite around them in a circle and just kind of let them die. And that's kind of the strategy on how it goes. Magic weapon, the force weapon, just give you a big increase in damage as a passive damage there. Energy armor with prismatic armor, give me a big toughness increase, going to give you 35% armor and going to give you 25% all resist. Now, I went with all resist here, and the reason why I did is because my gear is practically optimized. So I have resistance in the secondary. I can actually pull this off and make it worth it. If you don't have optimized gear, another one would be good would be your energy armor right here, giving you incoming attacks that would deal more than 35% of your maximum life reduced to 35% of your maximum life instead. So, you know, it's just kind of gonna save you from getting hit really hard. But if you do have the correct gear, you don't need this. And then also pinpoint barrier is good if you're maybe doing a starter setup or something like that. And you know, you're doing T1, T2, T3, whatever the case may be. Maybe you're doing T6 and you don't need survivability because you have double unity. You can just max out some more damage there if you'd like. Then we have teleport with safe passage, by far my favorite one out of all of them. For 5 seconds after you teleport, you will take 25% less damage. Pretty much what will happen is something will tap you, you'll teleport. Something will tap you, you'll teleport. Something will tap you, you'll teleport. Over and over and over again, getting lots and lots of reduced damage. Very, very helpful. Black hole with blazer, as we talked about earlier, going to interact with your strong arm bracers, going to hold down the monsters for a minute and put an additional dot on there, which is very good. Now, the reason why you can teleport quite often is because you use illusionist, one of the strongest passives for the wizard. When you take more than 15% of your maximum life, which is going to happen a lot on the greater rifts, even if you have really good gear like mine, then it's going to reduce, it's going to get that cooldown back for you. So you're going to be able to teleport, get hit. Hit, teleport, get hit, and you're just going to get that reduction all the time and give you that mobility and kiting power that you need. Now, this also works really well with mirror images and slow time. Slow time is something I've messed around with, and it is kind of a viable option, so mess around with it if you like going with that route. Now, I would use slow time over maybe like black hole or maybe over hydra or something. Everything else kind of needs to stay. You might be able to take it over teleport if you want to, but I feel like if you get surrounded by monsters, you're pretty screwed. So teleport is a really great survival technique. Unstable anomaly, which is very, very, very strong, is going to be very useful in the higher greater rifts. Not so much in the lower, so you can go with some other passives if you want to, but yeah, very, very strong. The Firebirds itself, the four pieces, when you die, you come back and you have a 300 second cooldown on that. So one thing that's really great is that if I die, boom, my unstable anomaly hits. That, you know, that 60 seconds starts going. I die again, maybe 30 seconds later, because of some crazy rift that I'm in. We all have those really bad rifts. Die about 30 seconds later, and then boom, you know, your Firebirds will proc. And then about 10 seconds later, you die again, but your unstable anomaly's back up, and oh, you rinse and repeat, and you have to die a lot to actually die in a rift. And then even if you do die, the first time you die, you get to come back right away. So you have like a 9 lives pretty much as a wizard. But they can run out depending on the rifts, and you know, there are some crazy rifts out there. And then the last one, and then we have a glass cannon here. Glass cannon, all damage done increased by 15%, and your armor and resistance are cut down. Now, I have a lot of armor, I have a lot of resistance, and you know, I can get away with using something like this. However, we're going to show you some variations with glass cannon in a minute, and then blur, I just feel like it's great all the time, especially on those higher greater rifts. So now let's get into some item variations and build variations for you guys. All right, so now let's take a look at some item variations and build variations for you. So there are a few things that you can do. We talked about the amulet earlier. Now, some other amulets that would be notable and very good would be the prevent damage amulets. Now, this one is quite a good one. I do lose some damage here, unfortunately, so I kind of went with the more damage. And I do like the special property on the Voxo, but at the same time, I feel like because my toughness and stuff is everything, is kind of the way I'd like it. I don't really need the arcane prevent. Now you may need the arcane prevent because Jailer can, if Jailer's one-shotting you, you need this, like guaranteed, or you just lose, period. You're not gonna run into Jailer all the time, but still, yep. Any of the prevent ones are pretty good, but the best ones I would say for the wizard would be the cold one and the arcane one, and then the fire one. So those are the three best that you want to shoot for. The poison one's pretty good if you go against Gom for the Rift Guardian, but you know he can be kited throughout the entire map, and you pretty much need to do that anyways. You're not going to be standing close to a Rift Guardian anyways because of your Vengeance gem being far away from the monster. Now, the other one here, which I believe is the best amulet for the wizard, is the EOE, Eye of Icklitch. Now, this one here, you get reduced damage from ranged attacks by 33%. This can go up to 35%. Now, this one is a strength one. I got so many of these in Season 1 and never got a usable one, unfortunately. So, you know, this one right here is one of the closest ones that I actually did get on my barb, but very strong because when you get those high tiers and you have those little skeleton guys that are just pecking away at you with their little arrows while you're trying to kite everything, that damage can, you know, add up very quickly. So having that reduced damage is helpful. But I'd say that, you know, a good second or third place would be the prevent ones or maybe like the Vox. So if you have any other ones that you discovered that you think is pretty good, put it in the comments down below. Now, as far as the belts go, now you do have your Harrington's Wastegard, which you can use for T6 farming, which is fine and dandy. And then you also have your String of Ears. Now you can see a huge toughness increase here, reducing the damage from melee attacks. Very good. String of Ears and Witching Hour are both equally viable. People may think, no, Witching Hour is the best. No, on the high tiers, String of Ears and Witching Hour are equally viable. Now, what you'd want to do in the variation for this. Now, usually when I use Witching Hour, I will switch out Glass Cannon and use Elemental Exposure. This is going to give me 5% damage increase, and you don't want to mess with Audacity because you don't want to be close to monsters. You're not really going to be standing still. Some players run Dominance, but it's kind of interesting. The rest of the stuff just isn't really a factor. You can maybe go with Evocation, Conflagration, maybe as well, but I like the immediate 5% damage pretty much all the time because I'm always doing fire damage to everything. Now, if you were gonna go with a String of Ears, you do lose damage, but you gain toughness, so you could switch out this and go back to Glass Cannon. So now you kind of balance it a little bit more. You go up in a good bit of toughness, and you kind of balance your damage back up there. You can see that mine is 3.5 million, which is more than enough to take down those high tiers, 43, 44, 45s, more than enough. So definitely very, very good. Then we have the now if you were to maybe use like a Witching Hour in this situation, yeah, 3.9 is pretty crazy, and that's not even including the elite damage, but yeah, pretty crazy stuff right there. And those are some variations you can do there. So we also talked about earlier the Mage Fist Gloves. Now, Mage Fist Gloves are interesting. They're pretty good. Now, you can go with the Mage Fist Gloves if you want to. Now, this is going to look like a clear choice to go for because, yeah, you're going to have, you know, the attack speed is what's throwing this off right here. Now, attack speed is great with the Hydra, but you don't want to stack too much of it because your attack speed doesn't get affected anywhere else. So why would you put all your eggs into one basket? You want to kind of balance your stats out. So, you know, you can go with maybe the Mage Fist here instead of the Cinder Coat. You can do that if you want to, but they're both quite equal, so you're pretty much going to be, you know, losing that reduced resource and also that ranged attack thing that I talked about too on the secondary there. So that's why I go with the Cinder Coat, but both are definitely viable options. Attack speed is okay to get on there, but then I would definitely not use attack speed in here and go with the cooldown reduction instead. So especially if you're using a one-hander. Now, another variation you can do is going with the Furnace. Now, you can go with the Furnace and go instead of the Stone of Jordan and go with the Arena Royal Grandeur. You have to have a really good rolled one. And then you can keep the Cinder Coat there and you can throw on your now Ancient Furnace. Gotta keep that in mind. Regular Furnace is a no-go. Even the best rolled one in the game, no. You have to go with an Ancient Furnace, and it has to roll really, really good to even be an option. If not, Which is, then you're going to want to go with this combo right here. But those are some options. Now for some T6 farming strategies, you can go with the Serpent Sparker, which is great, having some more Hydras, which is cool. And this is something that actually does work pretty high in the into the tiers. If maybe you want to go with like the Mage Fist with the attack speed here, and then maybe go with like just stack all your stuff for Hydras and have double Hydras. That is kind of viable, and I've heard people doing 41s, 42s, 43s with that strategy. But I just don't like that kind of gameplay for me. Anyways, the Hydra misses a lot of times, and that's just something that I don't enjoy. But yeah, anyways, I like to go for the more immediate damage in my type of build here. And then here we have the oh so beautiful Wand of Woe. It looks so great. It's so awesome. You just want to kiss it. But yeah, Wand of Woe, I've heard people doing somewhat high tiers with Wand of Woe, maybe 39, 40, 41s. But mainly it's going to be your T6 farming item. And it's a very rare item. And it's ancient. That's why it's so beautiful. And it rolled so well. And yeah. So it just just makes you, yeah. Anyway, it's still nice to have and just to hold on to, but it is a viable thing you can do for T6 runs, like I said, and maybe up into the 33 through 39, 40s or something like that, if you do happen to get one there. But then that's a whole other build that I'd have to go over there. But yeah. Pretty much. So that is that right there. That's pretty much everything in a nutshell. This is all the stuff that I did and all the stuff that I used to get how I did. Also, the very last thing, sorry, was the armor potion. Love me some armor potion. Very great to use. You don't need the Zoltan Cool one, the Kool-Aid one, because you have teleport, so Waller doesn't really matter to you. Armor one is great. Now the resistance one that gives you all resist. So if that was like a percentage of resistance and they gave it to you, that would be pretty good because you have a lot of all resist, but you need armor more. It's more of a primary stat for you, so I feel like this is just the strongest one for you to go with. But that's pretty much it, guys. That is everything, and now let's go ahead and I'm going to show you guys some starter build variations that you can do to kind of help you out as soon as season 2 starts and what you're kind of shooting for. Now you know what you want to get to. Now we're going to show you how to start, and let's go ahead and get into that right now. All right, guys, so now I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of a starter build here just to get you going when you hit level 70 in season 2 if you do happen to play the wizard. Now this is all pretty much rare gear here. We have just getting int vitality is a huge priority, getting crit chance and crit damage when you can. These are just like crafted items right here. You can also spend blood shards to get some yellows to get you off the bat too, so getting blood shards while you're leveling up, spending them once you hit 70 and not beforehand will definitely be good. So yeah, pretty much just picking up everything here that you can. Getting sockets is very good. You want to go with the resistance sockets because the 62 int gems are just not going to be enough. You can go either way depending on your survivability, your health and everything, your toughness. But yeah, like getting crit chance, crit damage would have been great here. There's a lot of places that the gear could be more optimized. Just a little bit of an example for you guys. Now you can notice I'm using two legendaries and you're like, what, Shinobi, you're cheating. Well, these are both crafted legendaries and you can find the patterns for these very quickly. In the beginning of a season, you're going to find a lot of patterns right off the bat, especially the Reaper's Wraps. As soon as you hit 70, you kill Malathiel, you get the plan for it, you make the Reaper's Wraps. These ones are ancient. You can just roll them a bunch of times so you get the ones you want. This one don't have vitality on them, unfortunately, but it's decent. Just wanted to get some decent ones here. This one here, like the Devastator, the plan, like I said, you could find very quickly. Going to be a huge boost for you and help you out a lot. And getting an ancient one is just a matter of crafting a certain amount of them. And you can get it after the first one, or maybe the fifth one, or 50th, or whatever. But try and get a decent one and get going there with that. Now, you may not have a gift, so this is going to make this a little bit stronger because I get to have the additional 10% damage, but it's just a little bit less here. This is just an example, and we're playing on lower torment here, only on torment one. You can see that I have almost 10 million toughness, almost 500k damage, and I'm using no paragons. I'm only using movement speed. made for the purpose of the video to speed it up, but no paragons are being used on this day, except for the other ones that I showed you. As far as the build goes, just using a pretty basic build, just going with the same kind of stuff you normally use, resistant like prismatic armor, safe passage, Arcanaut here you're going to use because it's going to give you some arcane power back. Going to be using Astral Presence for some arcane power back and giving you some more arcane power. You do lose arcane power by using your energy armor, but you need the armor there to help you out. And you want to use Meteor with Meteor Shower, and this is a great thing to use. It's going to be very strong for you, very strong spammable fire ability you can use before you get Firebirds to get you off the ground a little bit. And when you couple it with the Reaper's Wraps and the passives and other things that I have, you can use it quite a lot. And, you know, 500k damage right now, it's not too bad. So you can see my Templar doesn't even have anything. Everything's pretty much naked. So we're on Torment 1 here. Let's just go to Festering Woods real quick. And let's see what this looks like. So just throw down some meteors. Pretty much kill everything. Things are dying. Pick up the health globe. Move along. There we go. And just keep it going. And that's pretty much it. It's a very basic thing for you. I could probably do much higher torment, so we'll give that a try in just a minute. There you go. Very simple. Very easy. Does a quite a bit of burst damage. Let's go kill the elite down here. See what that looks like. And it's just like right off the bat. As soon as you hit 70, man, like you can get going with this. So we're not going to take Frenzy because we don't want any additional help. So let's just do this real quick. Throw down these. Alright, running a little bit out of resources because single target's not going to be that great for you. Alright, need to get... There's some health globes in there, but I don't want to stand in that stuff. Alright. So obviously single target's going to be the worst thing for you. Blue packs would go down nice and quickly. Everything else would go down nice and quickly. Until at least you kind of get off the ground a little bit. Let's try a little bit higher of a torment. Let's just see what we can do. And this is just rare gear here. This is, you know, torment 1 the second you hit level 7. Well, not really the second because you'd have to have a Devastator plan. But you could use another, you know, if you got maybe a legendary, crappy legendary as soon as you hit 70 or something. You could use that instead. This is just going to give me some more fire damage right off the bat. Let's go ahead and switch that out real quick. Let's try a little bit different here. Surviving the damage and everything on T4 and rare gear right now. It's just if I had health pots, it would make this so much easier. But I didn't even buy any. This character has like nothing. But yeah, this takes quite a while. Obviously, you're going to have better gear at this point. But this is just a test to see a little bit of your survivability. And the survivability definitely is there. For sure. There we go. Get the health globes right there. Picking up those health globes. Make sure you just keep going around, picking up them health globes. Boom. And that's it. If I had some health pots, I probably would have been able to push damage a little bit faster. But, you know, it's just an example of what you could do. And, yeah, obviously that took a while to kill. But, like I said, you're going to have better gear when you hit level 70. You know, just like I said, right off the bat, Reaper's Wraps, Devastator, get them as quick as possible. The rest of the gear, you know, is... just whatever you find, you know, and then craft gear that you might need or whatever the case may be. But that'll get you going at least to start finding some really good stuff, doing those rifts, greater rifts, and all that kind of stuff. Get some good gear, and hopefully that'll get it all done for you. So anyways, that was it for this really long full guide tutorial for all this kind of stuff. And I hope you did find this information useful, as I will probably not be uploading another Firebird Wizard video for a little while at least. But going to be diving into some other classes and got a lot of class guides coming out this week. Hopefully, if I can get the schedules all working well and get everything done before season 2. Yeah, but that's about it, guys. Good luck in season 2 and your greater rifts and everything like that. Let me know how you do if you do play a wizard or even if you play any other classes or anything. And yeah, I will see you guys in season 2. All right. Until next time, my name is Shinobi, and thanks for watching.